Did you know what you were getting yourself into when you did Star Wars?
Not really, no. I turned it down. I said, I don't be stuck in a robot. What for goodness sake, you know. He said, you've got to do it. We can't find anybody else. You're small to get into it, and you're strong enough to be able to move it. And they couldn't use kids. Because they're not, you know, I mean, I'm short, and I'm not that strong, but I'm, you know what I mean?
Strong for the size, so to speak.
Concentrated power, you know. And I can work all hours, like 8 in the morning till 8 at night. You couldn't do that with kids. You see, so I was a godsend to them, really. You know, I got into it eventually, but they put the lid on me like a boiled egg, you know. Put the lid on, and it revolves on bearings.
Because I went too far, the wires would go around my neck, and then they'd say, cut, right, break for lunch. And everybody just walk away and leave me. And then they'd remember me, you know, eventually. But that happened many times.
And I had nuts, bolts and screws into my head, inside. Well, next morning I'm combing my hair, and I felt all these scabs on my head. I thought, where did I get those from? I thought something had biting me. And it was the nails and the screws in the head of the R2-D2. So the next day I had to have foam rubber put in the head to protect my head, you know. And I, you know, one thing, and these little silly things that well, had to be ironed out, you know, so that it worked.
Didn't think it was going to be any good. Whereas I didn't. I thought, what's it? This is a bit strange. And I can remember this lighting man. He said, what is all this about? He said, I can't, it's a load of rubbish, you know. And we all thought it the same at the time. I thought, yeah, this is a bit strange.
And I'm signing autographs, you see, in photographs. And this lady came up, she said, would you sign this? And she was about 30, 35. And I started to write on whatever it was she gave me to sign. And she burst into tears, see. So she was really crying. I said, what are you crying for? No, I never normally have this effect on women. She said, well, the thing is, I when I was a girl, a little girl, and Star Wars came out, R2-D2 was my parents were going through a divorce, and R2-D2 was the only thing that kept me happy. Just to take him to bed with me every night. How about that? They said I was driving erratically, and what it was my, I was just over the limit, just that much. Anyway, that happened, that was it.